Yeah.
Yeah.
No, it's
I
not
have
great.
No idea what your point is. So I shocked it, and you're like, maybe, yeah. Mm. I was like, okay.
There's hope.
Don't know what the
there's
comment.
There's hope in this game.
Like, yeah, of course, there's the game. Hope. There's always hope. There's a karma. Primal calamity. There is always hope. Oh, our sweet lady comes at exactly the right time. Focus up, nerds. It's time to enter the arena. With me, Riley Knight, and this week and every week joining me, as usual, Toralf Toffle Severin, the Mythic Champion.
I was thinking you dropped it.
No.
What?
Never going to drop that one. And also, Jamin Cal.
The Mysterious Wizard.
I like that. That's good.
No, in the world of Magic the Gathering, we're not wizards. We are planeswalkers. Here I rule, or something like that.
I think you're about 5 years too late with that, or maybe even 10, but yeah, exactly. Here we rule for
play
sure.
Play the game, see the world.
A very special edition of the Arena Boys. So special, in fact, boys, that you actually haven't seen the list we're playing. We promised to play an aggregate list of all the... what I've done, is mash together all 2,646 cards that we've played... Right over the last nearly year, and built from that, the Arena Boys All Stars.
Ah, what a nice feeling seeing a 5-color deck named Arena Boys All Stars.
The Arena Boys All Stars. So now you guys haven't seen this, so I'm just going to open it up, and I'm interested to see just some first impressions, and then I'll explain the methodology and how the deck came together, and we'll talk about it more. But just feast your eyes, my boys, and tell me what you think. If it ever loads. There we go. I'll pop this one over here and have a look at that.
I recognize some cards.
Oh, yeah.
Only 3 treasure maps is a bit disappointing.
Only 3. Yeah, that's how the numbers shook out. Only 3 of them. A lot more one-offs than I thought there would be, actually.
We should have made like a guessing game, like which card is totally on, because...
Yeah, what's this game called? Jeopardy? Where you like name a thing and...
No,
it's on
Family Feud. Yeah, Family Feud. That would have been good. Well, look, I've
got... Persistent Petitioner.
Oh, yeah. Oh, they made it. They made it on.
That averaged from one deck.
Yep. Oh, no, we played them in two decks. We had them in the sideboard of one of our Masterminds acquisition lists. Yep.
Oh, come on.
Yeah, no, we did. Yep, 21 copies of that total. Couple of interesting ones. Definitely hope we don't draw these guys. Definitely hope we don't draw them.
Because we don't play gates.
We play zero gates. Yeah. So we'll talk about the mana base basically, but it's just we start off with some basics.
We thought about that before.
And then it's just shocklands and checklands, but not all of the shocklands and not all of the checklands. Blood Crypt didn't make it. Temple Garden didn't make it. Woodland Cemetery didn't make it. We didn't play a lot of Dragonskull Summit. We didn't play a lot of Black Red apparently. There is one
Jungle's
card.
Not huge.
There is one card in here that doesn't deserve to be on it, actually. There is one card that has been... There's one card that's an invitational card rather than having earned its slot.
That's easy. That's too easy.
Which one is
it? Wait, an invitational? What is an invitational?
So this is a card. So basically what happened... I'll explain the methodologies we're playing, but basically there's one card. Basically I had 24 lands and 35 non-lands that fitted in evenly with like the way that I set up the numbers. There was one card I had to put in, however.
Honestly, so it's not a land, is it?
No, it's not a land.
No.
Okay, so then I have 2 options.
All right, go. Hit me.
It's either Zakama or Chromatic Lantern.
All right. Tough.
And I'll lock in Zakama.
Tough.
I was instantly looking at Incubation because I don't remember playing that a lot, but it's also not a card you would put in as a...
Oh, we need that extra consistency, yeah.
it, like you wouldn't say like, oh, this deck needs like an incubation. So I'm going for Fountain of Renewal.
Fountain of Renewal, actually one of the most played cards, surprisingly very high on the list. It was Zakama. Yes, it was, nice. of course, my special girl Zakama.
Too obvious.
Yeah. Well, I mean,
luckily I was first to pick because I think Toffel would have also gone for Zakama if he was first.
Thanks for making it yourself.
Maybe,
anyway,
maybe.
We'll talk about the stats and the facts and that sort of stuff. But one thing I like about it is it's actually got a decent curve and there's like a reasonable amount of removal and... Like, obviously, the mana is horrible, but the sort of...
I mean, let's sum it up. It has a reasonable curve,
yeah.
Good amounts of removal, yeah. Zakama, and the mana is horrible. I mean, that...
It's just, it is... I mean, it really came out on top as a pretty classic, pretty classic Arena Boys deck.
My favorite thing must be Kaya's Wrath with two mountains, four forests, and an island.
I mean, that's what you have the lantern for.
Cast this. Yeah. And the treasure maps, of course. Treasure map will help us cast all that. Anyway.
If we only win one match of this, the game is rigged. Like, there's...
Yeah. Well, look, I've been practicing with it. I've won a couple. It wasn't easy, and it took a long time.
Microwalker package.
Yeah, we got the full...
very strong one branch walker and one range.
Yeah, exactly. That's all we need. Anyway, before we start the videos, the game, of course. Obviously, little want to take just a moment, of course, to thank everyone who has been part of Arena Boys over the over the months.
You're
months
welcome.
And else.
I was part of Arena Boys.
Both my co-host, but also of course the viewers. You've helped us build something really quite special. We love making this series. It was a good time for us to reflect, at rotation, think about all the decks that we've played and all the cards that we've enjoyed playing, that sort of stuff. And, we wouldn't have been able to do it without you. Your support and your backing, the positivity and the continued, just general, the wind in our sails that we've got from all of our fans. Oh, sorry, hang on, I'm reading the wrong notes. Sorry, I wasn't meaning to say this about the fans. I was meaning to say this about ChannelFireball.com. The one reason that Arena Boys has made it to where it is today. Your number one place for magic strategy on the internet. And, of course, a range of competitively priced magic cards and accessories available for purchase at ChannelFireball.com.
It was so obvious that this was, like, some setup. I just couldn't pinpoint where it was going to go.
Yeah, you're sitting
actually,
there like,
I thought it was sincere.
Oh, really?
No. His voice was, like, cracking.
Yeah, I was losing a little bit towards the end there. It's been a team effort. I've done a lot of the work. Channel Fireball has done a lot of the work. And... other people have been involved as well, so thanks everyone.
Yeah, thank you, Channel Fireball.
And also, I guess a begrudging thank you to the fans as well. I guess you guys are all right. I'm very unsure how this one's going. I want to be optimistic.
I mean, if you add all, like, our decks tend to be extremely powerful.
That's very true.
And if you add all of them together, I mean. Wow. No Wander,
wow, this is
an absolute banger.
This is a great hand. Okay, this is an absolutely fantastic hand. Double incubation, double treasure map on turn three. Kidding me?
It's like we already planned all of this. Like, playing the cards that lead up to playing this deck.
Yeah, that's the thing. We should keep that in mind for next year, shouldn't we? We should bear in mind like which cards we are and we're not going to play.
Yeah.
So 1 year of mono red, and then we can, the aggregate list is at least good.
It's gonna be very, very good. All right. Okay, probably vampires here, or maybe just the old-fashioned mono white one. Oh, we can beat that. Oh, as well.
Wow.
This is all right. Great. All right, Druid.
So next time we do treasure map, scry and keep it. Fountain of Renewal.
Fountain of Renewal. Love that.
Playing in gold territory here. Is that?
Oh yeah. Oh, I mean, come on. A player of my caliber, gold four. Obviously. What do you think this is? All right, little vampires here.
I think this is a disaster.
This deck list surely is.
What are you talking about? This is a functional deck. I mean, this is a little bit of a problem, but that's fine. We'll deal with that. So treasure map, Fountain of Renewal, right?
Yeah, yes. And then we get to scry.
Okay, love it. All right.
The thing is, you didn't want to keep gold, apparently, because...
Yeah, actually, that's true. I should have tanked. I should have tanked, really. I shouldn't have got as far as gold. Oh, that's really annoying. That's very frustrating. And then we want a little white one, and I'll just put a stop here as well. Okay. No attacks. So, you ready for some stats, boys?
Always.
Ready for some stats?
We're called the Stats Boys for a reason.
We're called the, that was actually one of the that was one of the working names we had for a while. There was the Stats Boys.
Was it?
Our market research indicated that it wasn't going to go over so hot, so we ended up changing it to Arena Boys instead. A decision I regret every day.
We could just change it to Hot Stats Boys.
Hot Stats Boys, I like that. It's kind of like, you know, the GP, all the buy lists now are hot buy lists instead of just regular buy lists.
Yeah, you complain about that a lot.
I don't know why they're hot. Like, what? They're not. There's nothing hot about the buy lists.
I mean, what makes the singles in your area hot? I don't think buying a single treasure map is like.
And Jamin, of course, is talking about the hot singles that you can buy at channelfireball.com at very competitive prices.
Of course. What else would I be referring to?
I mean, those are the only hot singles I'm interested in.
I didn't think this was...
we got him, didn't we?
That much of a banger, but...
No, it's very good. Tuffle's a dirty boy. He loves that sort of gear. Oh, guys.
That's the best use for it.
Now, we can cast it.
No.
Yeah, but we can cast it, Jamin.
Yes, no.
No. I'm disappointed.
I'm interested in winning games of Magic.
Yeah?
And yet we play this.
Yeah, exactly. I don't know where you got your wires crossed somewhere. Ooh, another actual playable Magic card.
I mean, it's a 3/3. Like, it generates a 3/3.
So just make a 3/3, right?
And when we flip the maps, it's infinite. It's
enormous. All right. So we have to shock ourselves. That's not ideal, but that's okay. So, mate, play this. Yep. And
they even have to commit, like, multiple things. I guess the Vanguard alone kills it. It doesn't quite, like...
Also, any of the knights kill it.
Yeah.
But you look. We're looking on the bright side of life. Anyway, I got some stats. I'm gonna blow through these very quickly. Here's the stats, right? The top five all-time played cards in Arena Boys all had something in common.
Mm-hmm.
They're all treasure.
They're bad.
No, they're all very good. They've got long and storied histories because they're all a basic lands: forest, mountain, island, plains, swamp, in that order. Forest 143, so a lot more popular than mountain on 81, and then plains, island, swamp, all 57, 54, 52, very close. The sixth most played card,
Land of Elf.
Treasure map.
No.
Treasure map.
Of course.
Yep. Treasure map. Land of Elves, actually, interestingly, the only other non-land card that made it into top 10. It then goes Breeding Pool, Sacred Foundry, Clifftop Retreat. We played a lot of red-white, apparently. A lot of Deafening Clarions.
Yeah.
And then Land of Elf rounds out the top 10. So a lot of lands in the top 10, which is kind of boring, I guess. But also also makes sense. So.
Okay. I would really like Kaya's Wrath right now.
Can we cast it?
Can we have Ritual of Sword?
No, we didn't. I don't think we played Ritual of Sword enough. That's the thing, right? Here's a stat. Here's a fact, right? Guess how many times we played Ritual of Soot. Like, guess in how many decks we played Ritual of Soot.
Don't we want that?
Can we cast it?
Yes.
1, 2, 3, next 4. Turn. 5. Oh, okay, sure.
Oh, well.
5? Oh.
Okay, let me consult my enormous brain.
You're going to quickly Google it?
It's 2.
It is 2. It is actually 2. We only played Ritual of Soot twice.
And in both videos, we top decked it like crazy.
Yeah, in every single time we played Ritual of Soot, it was in like the video intro highlight. It was so good. Like, we should have played this every week.
It's most underrated card. Yeah.
It did so much work for us. Man, we're getting stomped here. Our opponent is taking their time as well.
Yeah, and I'm afraid this is a Champion of Dusk.
Yeah.
Womp womp.
Okay, draw a bunch of cards. What are they going to do with those cards, though? It's not like they've got... Oh, they do have a bunch of mana. Oops.
If our opponent also plays an aggregate list, they had a good year.
Yeah. For sure.
All right, are we dead?
You would take 3, more 6, than 9, 12. So yes.
All right, okay.
I mean, we were not alive.
No, I don't think we were ever really in that one. But you know what? We put on a good show. We cast some spells. Our ridiculous deck.
Yeah, we cast a Karn.
Yeah, exactly. That's a good card.
That almost did something.
Almost. Not quite. Difficult matchup, I would say. A little unfavorable, but broadly speaking, I think this list is still, you know, we still haven't seen the best this list has to offer. So let's keep going.
I'm I'm not sure how much this list has to offer, like in total.
Mm.
Yeah, but this feels like we have a lot of going to do.
Hey, listen. Listen. I had some really good match with it, all right?
Mm.
Some
I had note? Some I had some amazing game.
That sounds like a Yeti side.
Game, yeah.
This is a decent hand.
Yeah.
Keep it. All right. A little bit of ramp, a little bit of life gain, a little bit of selection. Oh, yes, please. So, fountain first or opt?
Against another fountain. Hallowed fountain, we can probably play fountain.
All right.
Yeah. We can keep that up.
All right.
We could have also just started with forest.
Why?
No, because then we can't play the fountain.
Oh, you want to play the fountain?
Yes. Oh, yes. We can opt later. We don't need to opt now. What do you opt for?
I don't know. I don't know.
Exactly.
Well, I think in this case it was quite clear that we opted for opt.
Well, apparently not.
Come on, that was a great joke.
No, I don't know. I'm not going to give that one to you either, Jamin. Sorry.
The thing is, Jamin, you have to differentiate.
I'm just going to do this now. I don't want to have to click through stuff.
Between great jokes for you and great jokes for the general public. Like,
I mean, yes, this was a small joke for me, but a big joke for humanity.
For humankind.
You see, that was a good one.
That was much better. I have to give you that one. That was much better.
In comparison, you have to a little bit to see, like, when I say, wow, that person is huge. He might be just like 160.
Just regular size, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right, what's on the agenda this time?
Probably Druid Fountain Opt. Something like that.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah.
Let's do that. Druid. We got a lot of forests as well for our Nissa. I love that.
I mean, that's just good deck building.
That's just good deck building. Hallowed Fountain along with Nissa who shakes the world.
Mm. I guess it's not good deck building at this point. Rather, it was good deck building throughout the year.
Yeah, exactly. And that's what we drove towards. Do you want this?
I think we... We really want to cast Nissa. Right?
I think we want this, right?
Tuffle, should we have done this at end of their turn, maybe?
The opt?
Yeah, maybe we should have cast it during their turn so we had more information. Tuffle. What do you think of that, Tuffle?
I feel like that's a bait. The
thing is, no, the thing just, is, like, honestly, I've like never, I was no, no, just no, no. Try, I was just trying to do it like quicker. Did I make a mistake?
You have to learn something. When Jamin sounds sincere and nice, there's always a trap.
Well, now it doesn't. Now
you,
it doesn't.
Do you honestly not realize the trap?
What? No, I realized it once you said it.
Oh, like, okay.
So we nearly got him.
My inner radar of Jamin saying stuff to me is just go on.
Yeah. Do we attack Teferi or do we?
No, definitely.
But I want to use. I want to cast two spells.
You can still Shadow Cast works for just attacking, right?
Yeah. Oh, that's true. Just draw two cards. Okay. Yeah. Right. I'll do that. All right. I really want to cast the Circuitous Route.
But... Yeah, but Tuffle, I feel you. I can also tell when like people are setting things up, right?
Yeah.
Like,
exactly. Yeah.
No. No more
games. All right. Like, draw two.
When your combo opponent like. Plays Dark Ritual, you can feel that they're like about to.
Does Divine Visitation only count for a creature token?
Creature tokens, yeah. Unfortunately, this doesn't start making angels, although that would be very sweet.
Look, our treasure chest popped 4/4 angels.
Oh, that's what was it? That's the real treasure all along. 4/4 angels. Yeah.
Who cares about the journey and friends?
Oh, okay.
If you want to scry in our upkeep,
yes. That's why I put the stop there. Actually, you don't need the stop there with this. This is like a little insurance policy.
Nice.
Yep. Okay. Resolve. And...
We need something to get rid of the thief. No.
Okay.
I mean, jokes on them. What they're going to take from our deck.
Oh. Perfect.
Turns out nothing.
Yep. So, lava coil that. Get out of here. And then, do we need to still attack Teferi?
Oh, do they have Dovin's Veto?
They may have something. I don't know if this is the Hero Precinct 1 deck or just like a weird Esper Control build.
At this point, I cannot differentiate between standard decks.
Yeah. Tyrant's Swarm. Okay, that's fine.
It's just impossible. I played a standard PTQ and like, you couldn't tell the difference.
Should I attack?
I think it's not the Kethis deck.
Yeah, okay.
It's not mono red.
Play the root.
Play the root, okay. I don't like that. I guess just...
No, but at this point, it just all blends together into a mix of, like, Teferis, small or big, Thieves, Risen Reefs,
Yep.
Graces, Nexus of Fate, Gates,
Scape Shift.
I don't know why people don't like Standard at the moment. I think Standard's been great. I guess people are just ready for a bit of a change.
Oh, what a rude thing to do.
Going after a treasure map? No, I don't need this upkeep stop.
Also, how do you detain a treasure map? Someone explain that.
I guess you confiscate it, don't you?
Yeah, but that's not detention.
Yeah, exactly.
No.
What?
I wanted to draw a card with the fountain.
Okay. I mean, this isn't doing a whole lot, to be honest, unless we get, like, what, Legion's Landing or something? Ooh.
There we go.
That's good.
I mean, maybe not really, but... We'll what? See.
What, this card?
No, just in general. Like, picking up the shock has, like... Yeah.
Yeah.
No, it's
I
not
have no
great.
Idea what your point is. So I shocked it, and you were like, maybe, yeah, okay.
There's hope.
Don't know what the comment.
There's hope in this game. Like,
yeah, of course there's the hope. Game. There's always hope because this is a karma. Primal Calamity. There is always hope. Oh, our sweet lady comes at exactly the right time.
So what does
we
she do?
Shoot down both creatures, and then we need to attack
we can.
Yeah, Teferi.
All right, shoot this. Go away.
Shush, go away.
Oh, marvelous.
Make way.
Okay. Detention's over. And now attack Sorin?
Yeah.
Or Teferi or...
Probably Sorin.
Sorin? Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, Teferi doesn't do too much.
I mean, if Teferi bounces the karma, that's fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
We got the map
Sorin.
Back.
Yep. Scry. Scry and our upkeep next turn. Don't need that.
And they made way for Druid of the Cowl, Prince Druid of the Cowl.
Fantastic. Oh, boo!
No! That's very rude.
Unfair. We're also really, really running out of removal. We've already used Shock and Lava Coil.
Wait, they just play the same cards.
Yeah, I know. How unfair. Okay.
All right.
Scry.
Find something.
Give me something good here. Come on.
Kaya's Wrath.
Nope. Kaya's
One
Wrath.
One time!
Kaya's Wrath. Kaya's Wrath. Kaya's Wrath. Nah. Didn't work this time. All right, well.
What's the thing we have with the visitation?
Legion's Landing.
Right.
Also Karn.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Our sweet lady. Not quite enough. Oh,
wise. Made it.
Very wise. Yep. Yeah, I think our opponent finally realized what our deck is trying to do. This is going to be wild. They're going to look at three cards and be like, what is this? Okay, nice easy decision for them there.
Oh, how lucky. Getting the best card.
How dare they? Oh, I've done the hero thing before. Okay. What's next? Come on, something good. Scry. Okay.
Ooh, yes, yes.
Now, it won't untap our lands.
But we don't pay as much.
But that's fine, right? Yeah, that doesn't... No, I was just wondering, like, should I float a bunch of mana beforehand? But no, it doesn't make any difference. All right, give me this.
Oh!
And they don't have anything. All right. Okay, so... Yeah,
let's get rid of the thief.
We can get rid of the thief. Not only can we get rid of the thief, Jamin, though...
We can also get rid of our own treasure map.
We can get rid of the treasure map. Return it to, well, not return it to its rightful owner, but at least, you know, give it some dignity in death.
Make that do that before...
Yeah, of course. I'm not going to give him another scry. Don't worry about that. Disenchant this. Oh, Zakama.
Which enchant?
Dat enchant. I'll dat enchant. Okay. Dat one over there. All right.
And that joke will never get old.
No, oh no.
There will be no point in time where that joke is not an absolute banger.
When we're the arena grandpas, we'll still be doing that. which enchant, Jamin? Dat enchant, Riley? Love it. That's how old people talk, apparently. All right, here we go.
Draw an additional card with treasure
code. Draw a card here. Draw a card, see what's going on. Love it.
I feel like there can't be any better scenario than this game.
This is, yeah, we've reached max peak performance. Good. I think we just go upstairs. What do you think?
Yeah. They're dead next turn, though.
Yeah. I'll send that a little bit of respect for Teferi.
Yeah,
I love that. That's good. All right, okay, get in there. Get in there, special lady. Go, bang, love it. And play this one as well. See something good on top? I mean, there's not really,
I mean, if we play around another deputy.
Let's keep it, yeah. I mean, we don't. The thing is, we don't need any other. This card does it all. We don't need anything else.
Deputy doesn't do anything against the Karma.
Oh, true.
When you've got mana untapped, yeah. That's
come
true,
on,
yeah.
Toffel. You have to leave us mortals, like.
Okay.
Well, it doesn't have to do anything with Teferi, so I see it.
Okay. All right. So we need to.
We can just kill this. I mean, we just. I think we just got him, right?
Yeah, I think so too.
Okay.
Seraph of the Scales. I'm interested to see how well this card performs after rotation.
Yeah, because it's got a high power level, right?
Like, it's Lingering Souls on
a
4-mana 4/3.
Guys, we did it.
We won a game with
with the Arena Boys All-Stars. And you know what? I think that'll do it. I think that's just about it, because they say you should end on a high. They say you should, you know, quit while you're ahead. And I don't think it's going to get much better than that one.
I mean, we're as far ahead as you can get with this deck at 1-1.
At 1-1, I think is, yes, a very good time for us to bow out. Oh, but hang on.
May I suggest a better deck?
Well, I was going to say, we've got a lot of time left to fill. I really don't want to...
of any of the others?
Just select another deck randomly and play that one? Do you want to... Should we do that? Actually, should we do that? Should we have a trip down memory lane? Jamie, do you want to play an old deck?
I mean... There is one that's special, that has a special place in my heart.
Okay, go on.
It's the one we played first. The one I registered for the PT. And the one that's actually a good deck. You know, you always make jokes about this not being good deck.
Okay, I was with you. I got you at the first points, but then you say it's a good deck, and that's where you lost me. Are you sure we're talking about the same one?
It's not a good deck anymore, probably, because it doesn't play Stomping Grounds. It doesn't play the new 2/3 Dinosaur. You know, but...
No, I love this. This is great. Let's have a little trip down memory lane and remember, back to our roots with this.
See,
oh,
this
Timber Gorge.
Yes.
Love it. What do you think of this hand, Topple?
It drives
it's perfect. No, play Timber Gorge. Play Timber Gorge turn one. This is exactly how we envisioned it back then.
Yeah.
Turn 2 Druid of the Cowl to block all of aggro's.
Yep. I don't know about how excited he is about this.
He's
turn
loving it.
Turn 3 Unsealing.
Yeah.
And then turn 4 Payoff.
Okay. All right. It's all just come together. James is like a kid at Christmas here.
This is perfect.
Yeah, no, it really is. He's just loving life. Oh, very good. All right. I won't. I'm not going to block. They might have like Disfigure or something. I'm not taking the risk.
Which figure?
That figure.
Sorry.
Oh wow.
Okay.
So how did you plan for huge dinosaurs?
So we can kill this.
We can kill it. No.
Yeah.
We can't even kill it next turn.
No, that's true. We can't.
Oh,
kill it
you
next
see
turn.
This combo? Oh god, Jamin.
Oh yuck. Oh no.
Which combo?
The return a creature to your hand.
Oh,
yeah, that's actually
which combo? Ask when your opponent has two cards on their battlefield. It's like, what is this?
That's pretty good. I mean, even just this and this is pretty good as well.
You want to hear a combo I love?
Yeah,
Sarkin's Unsealing.
Yeah, and four power creatures.
I can tell you a combo you play all the time.
Does it have to do with conceding?
Yes, it's the cock we are conceding. Good, very good.
All right, have we got anything?
Well,
just
we have
to raptor and the knight.
I mean, if everything draws a card, we can kind of stabilize.
Okay. All right. So Ripjaw raptor and kill the knight.
Yeah.
Easy game.
Easy game. Are you sure we shouldn't have killed the Eternal Taskmaster?
I mean, they kind of get it back, right?
Yeah.
But Jamin thought of that, I think.
Because we could have Lava Coiled the Knight. Or we could have.
We already mentioned the combo like a round ago.
Yeah. Say again, Jamin.
You can tell that this deck is from a different...
A different era.
Standard format.
It's from a different time.
No, honestly, in recent times, power level has picked up.
So...
That's good.
Take it?
No, block it.
Block, all right.
Block.
Dang. I was trying to set up a situation where we could maybe finish this off with a Lava Coil, but I don't know. I don't know, man. I don't know. I'm trying. Like, I'm trying real hard.
Okay, we have to commune.
Commune. We have to find another one.
All right. Ooh.
Okay.
So we can't cast this.
No, we take the...
Just the Ripjaw Raptor. Yeah. All right. Okay, sure.
And then we shoot the other one, then we block again, and then I think this looks pretty decent.
Yeah, look. Look at that.
What is this Gutterbones doing?
Oh, they didn't return it to the hand.
No.
Well, I mean, it's doing its best.
Because they were just discarded? All right, so block. Block?
Yeah, block.
Block, all right.
But, I mean, does it come back?
No, it only comes back when we're dealt damage.
Of course, they didn't do damage. Yeah, of course, they can't.
Oh, because we always block.
Yeah.
Okay.
Ah, smart. Galaxy brain plays here. Okay, so, Jamin.
Yeah, but no, this... Oh, actually...
I think we do. We play these two, right?
And then if they don't... Yeah.
All right, so we go Druid of the Cowl to block, and then another Sarkhan's Unsealing. And then we play this next turn, and they take, like, what?
Eight.
They take... Oh, okay. All right. I thought the top end of that was a better payoff, but apparently not. All right. Okay, yep. I mean, it kills the Rotting Regisaur.
Yeah. And the Gutter Bones as well.
It gets everything.
All right, here we go. Carnage Tyrant back one more tilt at the windmill here.
Wumps.
Double Sarkhan's Unsealing, taking care of business.
Wumps.
During that standard, like, Carnage Tyrant was, like, just unbeatable.
Yeah, it was, like 40 black bucks. Green.
Yeah, you just couldn't beat that card.
Oh, well, I'm very glad it's doing it again. Ah, oh, drill bit. Too little, too late, my friend. Too little, too late.
Like, Carnage Tyrant being the best thing to do.
we just got back in our time machine, mate.
Also, there weren't really cards that handled it pretty well.
No, you had to play, like, Settle the Wreckage back then in the control decks. And then all the Jeskai control decks started shifting towards, like, tapping out because they realized they wouldn't want to play the reactive game against, like, Carnage Tyrant.
Yeah.
And they were, like, Jeskai
control decks. Counterspell.
Yeah, exactly. There were control decks that were, like, with Treasure Map and Niv-Mizzet.
Boys. Oh, boys. And, what a triumph. What a triumph for Sarkhan's Unsealing.
What a triumph is that?
Oh.
Okay.
Talk about a curtain call. Wow. Okay, well, again, Jamin, I don't think we can play any more games with Sarkhan's Unsealing because I think we've just peaked with that one as well. Oh, my goodness. Toffle, you want to pick a deck for us to play this time, mate?
Yeah, of course.
All right, go on then. What do we got?
What do we have? Man, we played so many decks.
We played some real, real good decks, huh?
Oh, wait, there's the Niv-Mizzet one. Let's take this one.
Which one? Niv-Mizzet. Oh, the five color. Yeah, where is it?
It's right there, next to the Citadel.
Next to the Citadel. Gold? Here it is. Yep. Yes. Sweet. All right,
great.
All right. Excellent.
Remember when we always guessed how many cards we had and I always win?
You didn't always win.
I don't remember that part, actually.
No chance to prove that.
For those of you interested in the list that we're playing, of course, if you can search for the... If you just type in, like, Arena Boys Niv-Mizzet, you'll find the list that we're playing. I'll pop it up on the screen, actually, so you can, like, pause the video and screenshot it if you haven't seen the list. Because these are lists that we played ages and ages ago.
It's not only the list, also, like, Rockets and the Arena Boys flying through the screen.
Nope, not doing that. Nope, actual not. Nope. Because I've got it. You know that I have to leave my house tomorrow at 5 o'clock in the morning to get on a flight to Bavaria, and I'm editing this tonight. So no, this is going to be a 5-minute one and done job. No rockets this time.
Aww.
All right. Keep this. This is great.
Bang over hand.
Great hand.
I like the synergy between Rupture Spire and Chromatic Sphere Lantern. Breeding Pool.
Breeding Pool, I guess. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Okay.
Yeah. Oh man, those lands.
Against Mono Red, this is gonna be an interesting one, I would say.
I mean, we do have Knight of Autumn in the deck.
That's true. We have Solar Blaze as well. Which
so now
doesn't...
we play the Spire.
Yes.
Yeah.
We probably should have played the Sacred Foundry first. So now we could despark. Technically.
Oh, right.
But doesn't despark exile four or more?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can pass.
Oh, that's what you mean.
Okay.
Okay, we definitely want lantern. To cast. Yeah, but yeah, I think actually that was good. So now we can play Lantern untapped. Yeah, okay. We got you.
All right.
Very good. So now we just need to survive.
I mean, Solar Blaze is going to help us do that a little bit. Okay, that is going to do the opposite. But I guess we can despark her.
Yeah, we could just, like, this turn we can Tolzimir. Isn't that better than Solar Blaze?
Is that better?
Because it kills the Chain Whirler, gains life, and is a blocker.
And is a blocker. I like that. What do you think, Tuffle?
Yeah.
All right.
Fair.
Oh, no. Guys, we don't have white. Ah, don't worry about it. We've got Chromatic Lantern and Rupture Spire. Perfect mana. Easy game. So Chain Wheeler.
Do we have to kill the Chain Wheeler?
I wondered about that too.
Maybe it's better to kill this and then we can block the... No, because... No, no.
I mean, we can never block it.
No.
But then again, like, are we solo blazing or Niv-Mizzet-ing anyway soon?
I don't think we are.
I think what we can
actually,
do is...
Actually, yes, next turn we can do Solar Blaze, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So we kill a small one, then we double block
we
the
We have to kill Lava Runner, because Lava Runner doesn't die to Solar Blaze.
Yeah?
Yes, and then we double block and they use a spell to kill both, and then they use the spell that's not for us, and then we can despark the Chandra and...
And so, oh, and Solar Blaze next turn. Yeah, that's very good, actually. All right.
So we hope that their play is like another Chain Dweller. No, no.
Okay. So that's, no, that's not the end
of
the world.
That has the same outcome.
Yeah, like
we just chump now, yeah.
We just chump and then and take zero.
Okay, okay, okay.
So
okay.
We go down to eight.
So pay two. Yep.
Yeah.
Okay, Trophy is not the worst.
Pay two, yes. And then Solar Blaze... Okay, so that kills these two, and then, okay, yep, sure.
Yes.
I mean, if we get burnt out, we get burnt out. And then, despark Chandra, right?
Yes.
Yep. Very good. Auto targets as well, no other permanents that it can target. Excellent, all right. And now we just reload with Niv-Mizzet Reborn, gain a bunch of life, our flies out, here we go, we got a counter spell. Do you want to cast Niv-Mizzet?
Yeah.
Yes, four.
Yeah? All right.
Four.
Ten.
Four.
Five.
All right, Niv, come on. Give us the good stuff, mate. Five. No, it is four.
No, it's four.
It's four.
Damn it.
Woo!
All right.
Damn it.
Which one of these do you want?
Probably the warrant. The deputy does.
Yeah, warrant.
Warrant. All right.
Ooh, right. And Vraska gains his life, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
So, okay.
Gateway Plaza.
One time. One turn. We untap next turn and we basically win, right?
I'm pretty sure.
Vraska plus Ionize backup.
I'm pretty sure. Like, they have to find, I guess, like... Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Great. Oh, Knight of Autumn.
Knight of Autumn.
Oh, my goodness. All right. So, Knight of Autumn. Gain four. What have they got? A shock? Okay. No. No. Not like
stop,
this.
Stop. We have Ionize.
Okay.
Okay. No, no, we don't do that.
No. We don't need to counter that.
Okay, so let that one happen?
Yeah.
Okay, shock.
We go to one,
down to
and
one.
Then we go to five.
And then we go back up to five.
Ooh.
And then...
There's not a single card that deals five. They could have, like, light up the stage into Lightning Strike Skewer.
Yeah.
We don't need to play anything.
Think, yeah, we just pass with Ionize up and attack.
Okay.
Yeah. We don't want them to Frenzy or something.
Yeah. Yeah, there are ways for them to gain, like, extra cards per turn, I suppose. All right. Come on. Mono Red, the bad guy. Okay, that's fine.
That doesn't matter.
Just mortify that.
Easy game.
So easy. Wow.
Strong.
This five-color pile of garbage just beats out Mono Red easily.
Wait,
right.
Whoa. We played the aggregate list today. If anything, it's a five-color pile.
This isn't even the silliest deck we've played today. All right. I don't really want to sacrifice a permanent, though.
Stuff doesn't matter.
Things don't matter. Yeah, okay. All right.
As long as you leave up Ionize to counter the card they draw.
Okay, fine. I won't gain life. And I'll play this and pass the turn. Man, Chromatic Land, what a card. I'm very pleased we get to another year with this card.
Woo!
Yes! All right, looks like we can't play with Niv-Mizzet again, seeing as we've peaked here.
Ding, ding, ding.
Do I get to pick one now?
Yeah, no. Now you have to follow up.
You know which one I'm going to pick. All right.
No. Right,
So very quick. Very quickly, for those of you who want to see the list we played, there's the Unsealing one. Complete with
like
zero copies of Sacred Foundry.
Do they even have time? How much time do they have to play the decklist?
Because... Well, in the format historic, all the time in the world. And then this was the a lot of singletons in this one as well. So you can,
I mean,
you
can it is Niv-Mizzet.
Pause and have a look at that if you want. There it is. There. All right. Well, I know which one I'm picking. Very, very easy choice for me. Oh yeah. Oh, yeah.
The one that Riley is always talking about.
I love this one. So this is the one where you want to cast Phyrexian Scriptures and then follow it up with Fall of the Thran. And we... Oh, this is the one with the perfect sideboard as well. Remember this one? Mm. The 14-card perfect sideboard that doesn't need anything changed in it at all.
There's one reason why we had to play Petitioners.
We had an extra copy with it. Oops. All right, let's begin. All the way down here.
I remember parts of the recording with this deck. I remember that it went really well.
Yes, yeah. Well, I think... I don't know if I've mentioned this before, but this is the video that I use... When I'm trying to like sell someone on the Arena Boys, when I'm trying to show them what we're kind of like all about.
Okay, yeah. I don't think that like selling people is part of the Arena Boys marketing strategy.
Okay, mate. All right, very good. All right, this will do. Ooh, Chromatic
Lantern. That's great.
Love it.
Oh, Wumble Combo.
Yeah, so we put away Fall or something?
Wait, we should be scrying, shouldn't we? What's going on? This is very odd. It's unusual.
Was it that time?
Yeah. No, don't put away Dawn.
Like don't put away the combo. Yeah, so we have to put either Dawn or Fountain.
No! What?
What do you mean? What would you have put away, Jamin?
This was the combo that we were talking about.
No, Fountain this is the combo we're talking about, man.
Ugh.
Man, what a rookie.
Yeah, exactly. Come on, lift your game, mate. No, in fairness, I did actually talk a huge game about Fountain of Renewal and Dawn of Hope.
Yeah, but that's the secondary combo.
It's the secondary combo, exactly. So play that?
Sure.
I guess so. we got life coming out of our ears here.
We need one more land.
Am I good to go? Oh no, this is a stupid can never F6 card.
Aw, no F6 for Riley.
I'm so sorry to all of our viewers.
Press F for respect, but not F6.
Yeah, don't. Press F for respect. All right, good.
Oh, yes.
Good. Here we go. The thing is, ramping out Phyrexian Scriptures Fall of the Thran is not that good, right?
No.
Not really, no.
Because we're not going to destroy as many of their lands.
But we can set it up.
Yeah.
I mean, Fall of the Thran and Cleric is already a combo, right?
Okay, shocking that. All right, that's fine.
Yeah.
So the way it worked was you have to cast the scriptures and then next turn cast the four. Right?
You have to go one into the other, exactly. Because by the time the third trigger goes off here, it exiles all the lands that were destroyed. Okay, don't care about that.
Do we draw cards somewhere? I guess not. We don't really.
Okay, we don't do it now. Pardon?
We have to draw a card.
Do you think so, Toffel? Do you think that's a good idea for me to activate the ability of Fountain of Renewal?
Wow.
This is a mythic
champion we're talking about. I'm not going to cast this, right?
No.
Because there's no way we can cast that next turn.
I think I didn't tell you that. You know what I did in the PDQ?
What did you do?
I played against Scapeshift and I had a power plant, a tower, a map, a Karn, another tower, and an Ulamog. That was my hand.
Yeah.
I didn't win that game. I was always also going first.
Okay. What happened?
Because I played map. Yeah. I played a tower. I said go. My opponent played Farseek. I looked for a power plant, and then I wanted to cast Karn.
Oh, and you didn't have Tron?
No, because I looked for the wrong piece. Then I just died.
Nice.
Wow.
Yeah.
A mythic champion. All right.
Yeah, I saved all my Brainiac moves for the program.
Yeah, that's it. You're all out. Okay, let's draw a card.
Let's draw and
this one's looking grim.
Yeah, kind of.
Yeah, it looks like I don't get to pick the decks anymore.
The thing is also back then there were no planeswalkers really.
Yeah, so. you didn't have to worry about stuff like that. Back in the good old days before they killed Magic with War of the Spark.
Yeah, Magic is actually like this time it's for real. It's dying.
Wasn't the goal of War of the Spark that the magic isn't dead?
Well, they obviously failed there because magic is... I mean, everyone knows magic is the worst that it's ever been, right?
Yeah.
Well, that's grim.
All right.
I mean, currently we're visiting all of the grim fairy tales, so...
Yeah, that is true. It's only getting grimmer.
But not like Jasper Grimmer, because he quit Magic.
That's a joke that only about 15 people are going to understand. But I hope those 15 people enjoy it. Maximilian Blaubeer, I hope you enjoyed that joke.
That's 14 people more on average than his usual jokes.
Oh, dear.
I'm sure more than 15 people know Jasper Grimmer.
Do I even scry this like in the upkeep, or do we just naturally draw the
land?
I mean, we don't cast Fall of the Thrand this turn, do we?
Oh, that's true. Okay. All right, let's go.
There's also no real reason. Like, we're not looking for anything specific.
Also, we're getting attacked for 8 this turn, and then for 12 the next one.
Okay. Oh. Wow. Rude.
That's just rude.
That's rude, I would say. That is rude. Ha, huh, never mind. Have a spare. Nope. Again? Ah. You know what? I'm not going to miss Treasure Map as a card, as a concept. I will miss it terribly as a card and as a concept. I'll miss it very... Like, it'll leave a big Treasure Map-sized hole in my heart. Except for me trying to cast cards in the draw step.
Yeah. Yep. Of course.
All right. Okay. This one's looking pretty bad. I have to say, boys. It's not looking good. Scriptures?
Cast Scriptures, yeah.
Yep.
I mean, if we go down, like, we will go down because we're getting attacked for 8 here.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you said that last turn, and it ended up being even more disastrous, so...
Yeah, but if we go down, we go down, like, with our opponent having 0 lands.
We go down swinging, exactly. We send a message. We assert our dominance, Jaimin.
Honestly, like, I think the War of the Spark Planeswalkers are some of the worst things that could have happened to this deck, because Teferi bounces the Scripture, like, the Saga.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Also, Planeswalkers are, like, permanents that, like, are hard to get rid of that also, like...
That don't care about if you play... Like, if you've got 3 Planeswalkers out and you don't have any land, you're like, all right, sure, I don't care about that.
If you're 3 Planeswalkers ahead of your opponent and they play Armageddon, you're like, yes, please.
Yeah. Well, we're doing it, boys.
But I guess, as it stands, since they didn't cast Sarkhan, like, they don't have actual pressure going on.
No. I mean... I don't know how
except for all the cards.
And yeah. Except for 6 cards in hand and, you know, yeah. Is this just going to get counted? Or are they reading it? Okay. Oh, wow. A bold move.
Oh. Okay. Okay, so now they have a 1/1 servo.
Okay. Now they've got pressure, Jaimin.
Can just bounce anything, right?
Yeah.
Oh, so they can bounce the scriptures?
Oh, they just bounce the
scriptures.
Hang on.
We have to do this. Which one is it? Auto triggered abilities. Yeah, so they bounced the scriptures there. Ah. They cracked the code. They cracked the case.
How lucky.
Yeah, how lucky. How lucky can one player be? Oh, dear. Not ideal. You know, we said we're going to go down swinging, and then we, you know, wound up a big haymaker and then just sort of fell on our faces.
I mean, we went down swinging.
Yeah, just the wrong way.
Swing and a miss, but swinging.
Swinging and missing. I mean, what is there that's going to get us back in this? Like, nothing, right?
I don't know. Is there, like... No.
No? I mean, there's no... We're not playing, like, the Elder spell.
No.
I don't know. Should we just pack it up? We're dead, right? We're so dead.
Yeah. I agree.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Sorry, boys. I made a bad choice. I did a bad thing. After the absolute success of unsealing and the Niv-Mizzet, and now I can't. Okay, I'm not allowed to pick decks anymore. Jaimin, why don't you pick another one for us here?
All right. Can you show me the list?
Go on.
Oh, I remember some of them going not so well.
Yeah.
Well, let's pick the intro to Jeskai Legends.
do one that went really well. What's the best one we've had?
I mean, the best intro we ever had is Citadel Midrange.
Do you want to do Citadel Midrange?
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah.
That was some supreme deck building.
Yes, exactly. That was when we ripped the God Eternal Ronus and got in for exactly lethal when we were dead next turn. That
because
was
of Samud, which we also ripped.
Yes, we also ripped, exactly.
Citadel, Samud, Jade Light Ranger, Ronus or something.
All right, let's do it. Love it. Love it. Where are we? Yep. Fantastic. So I think, like, the other important thing about all the decks we played, like, this is, like, yeah, apart from in Historic, this is their last hurrah. We don't really have plans to play Historic. We might if there's, like, a special reason to or something, but I think for the most part we're just going to be moving on to Throne of Eldraine and the stuff that we're excited about for that. This week's article, of course, there's lots of stuff. Yeah, and in this week's article, of course, if those of you who haven't seen on ChannelFireball.com, you can read this week's article that has a couple of little brewskis that we've been working on. Dread Presence and Ayula, of course, is one of the ones that I'm keen to get underway. I want to do something with Garruk as well, but the wolves, there's not a lot of wolves. Like Wolf Tribal, I think, would be a lot of fun.
Ah, oh, mean thought erasure.
Yeah, nasty. Oh well.
Ooh.
Let's cast this on turn five. Don't worry about it.
We can.
Ooh, cast two of them.
Oh, so they didn't want the walker.
They probably can just counter it or something.
Yeah, but
another discard or something.
Okay.
But how do they take the walker if they have Oath of Kaya?
Yeah, that is odd.
Ooh.
Okay, that's good.
I like your style.
Yeah, just ripping pepperoni off the top there. Okay, land. Keep that, right?
Take it, yes.
Yeah. All right. Library.
Jade Light Ranger, also a card that kind of forgotten.
Yeah. The once like undisputed queen of standard, and now she's not doing a whole lot, huh?
Yeah, that card was crazy good.
Oh man, this has really been a nice little trip down memory lane.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Get in there.
I mean, everyone has like cards where they're like, oh yes, I remember this event where I played with that card.
Yeah, and... of course, yeah.
Yeah, like Urza's power plant.
Oh
yes.
Keep this?
Yes.
Alright.
Yeah, that's great with the
library.
Ranger.
Play that.
Oh, we're missing a swamp actually. Ugh.
Oh, we need another black source. That's alright. We'll get it. We got a basic swamp on top after the Rona, so don't worry about that. All right, there's a Narset.
So, that's a beating. I love it.
Why is it a beating?
Because Rona's doubles power and stuff.
Oh, as in we're giving them the beating?
Yes.
I thought you were saying Narset was a beating. I was like, I think it's fine. All right.
Attack 14.
All right.
Let's do that.
Let's get them.
We don't care about anything, yeah.
Upstairs. Bang. He's got Eternal Ronus once again, putting in the work.
I mean, Narset giving them another four looks at a sweeper.
Okay, well, let's see what they can find here. Teferi's not going to do it. They've got to deal with a lot of stuff. The Auto Rage is not going to do it. No. All right, this is good. They can Thought Erasure us, and then probably immediately concede because they see the power of two Bolas of Citadels.
I mean, none of which we can cast.
That doesn't matter. They don't know there's a basic swamp on the top of our library. Very wise. Okay, Teferi. So what does that do?
Yeah, that doesn't do it.
All right. Well done.
So
nice!
Oh, wow. Easy
we do.
Game. All right.
Sick.
Oh, yes.
Nice.
Okay, well, you guys are on an absolute tear.
My turn.
Yeah, exactly. All right. Okay, let's see what we got here. Damn devil. All right. Yeah, hit me. What do you want to rumble with?
Do the fire song thing.
Oh, this one. All right. Yes. Okay. So for those who missed this, this was almost a combo deck where we tried to play a True Fire Captain plus Star of Extinction to Naga opponents for 20 in one go, or just cast like a Fire Song and Sun Speaker plus any damage spell so we gained a bunch of life. Yeah, let's do that.
That was great.
It was good fun.
We went up to like hundreds of life, right?
Yeah.
We definitely hit triple figures.
Star of Extinction is still like the Planeswalkers are good for us, I think.
What do you mean?
Like, people playing with...
Oh, like you think it's well positioned. Sure. Yeah.
And I think with less black green midrange, like, yeah, I can see the stack still working.
All right, well let's get it done here. Love this hand. Oh, James, it's got your favorite card, isn't it?
Yeah.
You love a cheeky pillage.
I feel like that's a joke on my.
I mean, it's a joke at your expense because you like bad cards, but.
Okay.
That's
no.
it. That's the extent of it. It wasn't a deep cut.
Okay, all right. Against Mono Red, we have game.
Yep, I would say a healing potion is pretty good here. Deafening Clarion as well. Give all our creatures lifelink. Gain some life.
I feel like this game is just gonna sweep the board.
Say that again, sorry.
I feel like this game, the Deafening Clarion, is just gonna sweep the board.
I'll tell you now, I'm definitely gonna give my creatures lifelink. Should I lava coil the Steamkin though?
No.
I think we revitalize.
It's too unlikely Grosp to be.
Alright, okay. If they go like
if they have,
if it goes too big, we can still coil.
Okay. Yeah. Alright, that is a good, that's a fair point. It's just if they have one of those turns where they play like six cards. Alright, doesn't look like it.
Okay, just good. Okay. Apparently this turn they play zero cards unless they now strike us.
Hmm. No? Okay. Odd.
The it old nothing.
Me as odd.
Yeah. Just the just the big nothings there, alright? This is huge. It's like a 2-for-1 against Mono Red.
Yeah. Revitalize is like the Veil of Summer against Mono Red.
Yeah, yeah. All right.
And Veil of Summer is...
So, just...
Destroy everything.
All right. Lifelink. And I guess that one too. So important. I don't know how many Deafening Clarions I've cast where I haven't given creatures I control lifelink, but it's a very low number. It's like 2 maximum, I would say. And that's a misclick.
The question is, how many times did you actually give lifelink?
Yeah, something? How many creatures have actually been given lifelink by it? That I don't know. All right, what do you want to do here? Pirate's Pillage.
That's a bit annoying with Star.
Ooh. Oh, it's only a creature.
Yeah, so we Pirate's Pillage away the coil?
Fight with fire? I guess not. Yeah, coil.
No, I like...
We can't... You know,
yeah,
we
probably
can't,
coil.
We can't cast this unless we have that out.
We can't?
No, because that will kill us immediately.
No, I think it's just loyalty counters removed.
Go. Oh, okay. All right.
Is that true?
Yeah, actually, yes, it is. I've done that before. Yes, okay. It is, actually. Yeah. All right.
Well, it's not the fairy.
So, this one?
Yep.
Yes.
And discard...
The lava coil.
Lava coil. All right. 2 freshies. Ooh.
There is something juicy.
All right.
We even have time to do that, right? Because this turn, she goes up to 6.
Yes.
And then the turn after, we can starve extension.
The True Fire Captain shoots on players?
Yes.
It does.
So it doesn't kill the Chandra. No, because like if we play this, it just dies too easily.
So you want to get to 11 mana?
No, I want to play Fire Song and Sunspeaker.
Okay, sure.
Also, if we draw another land, we can play Fire Song, because then we will still have that additional treasure to cast Starve Extinction.
Okay. I mean, they're never beating that. They're never beating that amount of life. Great. All right. So
okay,
we do this.
So Fire Song.
Fire Song and Sunspeaker.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So rather than... I mean, you know, we could assemble the combo. We could 20 them, but we're just going to do the old-fashioned beat Mono Red by having, you know, 500,000 life and, yeah, easy.
I mean, now they basically have to spend 6 damage on Fire Song and Sunspeaker. Otherwise, they're insta-dead.
Okay. But I don't think... I mean, do they have that? I don't know what's in their hand. I don't think it's very good.
So it's nothing that kills it.
No. They've just been sitting on 4 cards for a long time. Okay, Runaway Steamkin, that's fine.
I feel like they have to have enough damage to kill Fire Song.
Any creature gives us life, right?
Mm. Okay.
They do.
Sad.
Very sad. But now we can probably cast True Fire Captain.
No. We have to
kill Chandra.
Oh, yeah, she's on 7. All right, fair enough. All right, so that's good. We're going to take a pasting from that, unfortunately.
I mean, yeah, 7. But all we're right. Still on 11 then.
So, Star of Extinction.
Ding, ding.
And just the animation. Remember this? Haven't seen this one for a while.
Boom.
Bang. Getcha. We're done here. All right, so we take 7. Not 20, thankfully. I think we're still in great shape here.
I mean, yeah, we're playing cards like Revitalize.
Yeah.
We can kick the fight with Fire Song. Play the champion. Why
play
not?
This?
Yeah. Huh. What are we doing?
I don't know. I didn't think we were casting it.
Why not?
And the other one.
And another one.
We only waited for the 2-for-1.
Yeah, right. Okay. All right. Take 3, mate. So now we just need a star off the top.
All right, it's time.
Yeah.
I'm going to use mine.
Oh,
it's one time. Oh, no!
He's absolutely just chucked it straight in the fire. Oh, very good. Oh, very good.
It's fair to say that was probably the most useless one-time method.
Yeah, I'd say so, yeah. All right. Okay. Well, can I have one more?
Yeah. One more.
Can I have one more?
One more.
I know that I sort of stuffed it up with the first choice that I made, and I'm really sorry. But I saw this one. Can we do this? Because this is the last chance we get. When it, like, Arcades, all the defenders sticking around, but Arcades is off.
Mm. All right, hit it.
All right, let's do it. Oh, suspicious, suspicious bookcase. We played some real stinkers. Oh, dear. This one went really well, though, because we had a couple, like, we had some ridiculous tower defense turns, I think. So let's see if we can run that one back.
Yeah.
All right. I hope my choice does a little bit better than last time. We'll see. But what a year it's been, huh? What a year it's been. What an experience it's been to create the Arena Boys for people to enjoy.
And it's now almost been a whole year now.
It has, yes. Yeah, it was actually almost a year to the day that we decided, like, that we... I mean, this isn't going to be, you know, no one actually saw this apart from the three of us, but this is, like, exactly around this time last year was when we started talking about, like, what we were going to do to create content and how we were going to, what, you know, what, in which direction we were going to go. And, man, the stars just kind of lined up, huh?
Yeah.
All three of us.
At the GP, somebody came to me and told, for my part, the biggest compliment you can ever give. Mm. And says, like, he likes to watch Arena Boys while sleeping, like, while falling asleep.
Yeah, that's such a huge compliment.
And that's, like, basically my only criteria for a podcast.
Yeah.
The first time someone said that, because I've got obviously my podcast, Half-Ass History, as well. When someone came out, when someone emailed me, and I'm not going to do the music or anything. Remember, I've got to do a 5-minute editing job, so there's not going to be any music or anything this time.
Ooh, nice.
Just the sundew, I guess.
Bookcase.
Oh, bookcase, yeah. Sorry. What was I thinking?
For flavor reasons.
Yes.
For flavor reasons, obviously.
And then we can also cast the...
The ingenuity? Is it
a... Yeah.
Incubation.
Incubation.
Incog something.
Don't try to pronounce it. It just English words are impossible.
The poster worker.
Yes.
Employee of the year, Tetsuko Mizawa.
I remember that joke.
Delivering the mail.
What a great joke that was.
It was a very good joke, yeah. But yeah, the first time someone told me that they went to sleep listening to my podcast, I was like, wow, is it that boring? But it is actually, yeah, I mean, it is actually a very nice thing. It's like, you know, because I've been there, you know, you listen to podcasts or comfort stuff that's comforting or nice or friendly or whatever else makes you feel safe. And I'm glad, I don't know, I'm glad that we have that effect on some people. Just high alert, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
And then smack.
Get seven, yeah.
Attack for seven. All right.
Makes sense.
And they're dead next turn.
Easy. Easy game. All right. What do they got? Risen Reef.
Oh, no. A Risen Reef. How sad.
Oh, wait. Hang on.
Land. Oh, land would have been so
land
sweet.
Land would have been sweet. Would have been getting with both. So what do we do here?
Attack. Hit it.
Yeah?
Yes. Right. They have to block.
Yeah. If they don't block, they're dead.
Okay. They probably
I mean,
do
if they block, they're dead. They're just dead.
There. We got them. Yeah. Yes.
Bum, bum.
Oh, that's easy
was that
game.
Turn four, right?
That was turn four
I
once again.
I think it was, yeah.
Turn four. Yep. Oh, wow.
We're actually grinding.
Yeah. This is the thing. I just need to go through and play a single game with all of the decks that we've got, and then I'll be bloody platinum in no time. All right, excellent. All right, I'm gonna call it there. I don't think I like this is. Oh, how incredible! Just, I mean, not only this video, but just, you know, just the journey that we've had over the last couple of months. And again, you know, I was kind of joking about it in the intro, but, you know, it means so much to us to have so many fans, you know, saying such positive. I've never seen a video series on YouTube with such wholesome positivity week in, week out in the comments.
Mm.
I mean, there's a lot of, you know, people teasing us and all that sort of stuff, but I've never seen, I mean, this, I'm not joking, this isn't a lead up to a joke or anything else like that. I've never seen such a positive community fostered on, you know, with a YouTube series like this before. It's incredible. And thank you so much to everyone who's being part of it.
Yeah, honestly, like, yeah, I don't know. Whenever I receive feedback about, like, people enjoying our content, it's just really good to hear. Like, incredibly good.
Yeah. It's incredible because we just did this, you know, for a bit of a laugh to hang out each week to make sure we stayed in touch and, you know, play a bit of magic and enjoy doing what we're doing. Now, you know, there are thousands of people around the world watching our dumb videos every week, and it's just staggering. It's such a humbling thing to be able to, you know, be part of. So thank you so, so much. Toffee, you want to say anything nice to all the people listening and watching?
I mean, you said it all. I just agree. All right. Does that count? An update is available.
All right, an update is available.
We're getting very clear messages here. This is the wind. You know, this is the at the Oscars when they start playing the music behind us as well, trying to get us a thing. All right, okay, all right. Well, that is going to do it for another episode of Arena Boys. Thanks for hanging out with us, of course. Throne of Eldraine upon us. I think more or less now, by the time that this video arrives, we should be able to get our hands on the new cards. Check the article for some of the lists that we're gonna be kicking around. But if you've got lists you want us to play, we are so keen to get our hands on them. So make sure you send them in to us. The best way to do that is via Twitter. You can send you can tweet at the Arena Boys, or you can send me a DM at Ryder Cree Tower.
Was that the
Toffle? This
now,
is the
Toffle,
cue.
You go. Yeah. Okay. Yep.
You can also write me a DM at Ryder Cree Tower,
and I'll pass it on. Yeah, I'm your secretary now.
At Toffle MTG.
At Jack
Mattress. I didn't see you there. Hello.
And at Jack Mattress, of course, yes, for everyone's favorite Jamin. I'll say it one more time. Thank you so much. I really don't, even with, you know, the faculty I have with English occasionally, it is very difficult to put into words what it means to me and to us as well to have, you know, such an amazing, wonderful group of people at our backs, and it's a privilege to be able to make these dumb videos for you week in and week out. So thank you so much. Anyway, that's that. We're done. We'll see you back here next week for Throne of Eldraine. Ha ha! Can't wait. It's gonna be so good.
I mean, hey, you need to say the
yeah. What is
happening? I was giving you guys a chance to put in a little bit of excitement and enthusiasm.
All right,
Throne of Eldraine, new decks, new cards.
Eldraine will be, you know what, we'll be playing Cavalcade of Calamity with a 2/4 that, like,
with Toffle's Invitational card. Yes, we will be. Don't worry about that. Don't worry about that, absolutely. Yeah, no, all sorts of fun stuff coming in the next couple of weeks and months. Anyway, that's it. We're done. We're out of here, and we'll see you next time. It's time to exit the arena.
Boys!